Okay, you can have a bit of a chat with your friends, but okay, please attend the class. Okay, I have to make a few disclaimers, okay, and also I have to acknowledge actually these notes come from Dr. Shaida lah, again, Dr. Shu, okay. She had already taught this course, okay, in the past few years, and our lecturers have been using this these notes, okay, since from her time. And yeah, and okay, I should thank her lah for the notes, okay. And then all the pictures, because some of the pictures here, they are maybe they have copyrights, okay. Maybe they are from companies, okay, from those medical companies, from those medical manufacturers, huh? So this slide is not meant for commercialization. Eh? This slide is not meant for commercialization. It doesn't mean that, okay, it's solely for education. Because we have to compare to ethics, lah, kan? Okay. First of all, okay, it's about the what you are going to learn in this course. Okay. This course provides an intensive coverage to medical electronics and bio instrumentation. Okay. So what are the okay, we have a lots of so-called bio instrumentation lah, kan? Even thermometer, we can say it's a bio instrumentation in some sense. Okay, but we are going to confine, yeah, that can limit. Yeah, we are going to limit. Okay, we are going to limit this course to few types of bio instrumentation. Okay, or medical equipments. So there are few that we covers. For instance, okay, sensors and instrumentation. Okay, for medical applications. Measurement of bio, that involves measurement of biosignals. Okay, for instance, like ECG, electrocardiogram, kan, for your ECG, okay, to check your to look this on the signal onto the signal of your heart. Okay, EEG, okay, we have it, yeah, we have it in our lab. Okay, EEG, we have a portable one, EEG, where we measure the brain signal, okay, and so we have our blood pressure and also our respiratory system. So all this will be covered in our course, okay. And okay, in the end of the course, okay, you guys are expected to understand, okay, various medical instrumentation in terms of their principles, okay, and you can demonstrate your ability to apply, okay, to evaluate, okay, to integrate basic sensors, okay, and you are able to design basic electronic circuits for medical application. So, okay, that's why we're learning this course, okay, we hope that, first of all, I would break this into few, what we call a few things that you should understand in the end of this course, or you will have this ability, okay? You understand the instrumentation principles or what type of principle that it applies, okay? Okay, so you can evaluate, okay? During the exam, okay, we ask you, okay, justify why you are going to use the system, okay, and so on, okay? And then you know how to integrate some basic sensors, okay? And then you can also design basic electronic circuits for medical application. So all this, okay, because but in the end of the day, at least you know, okay, this is ECG, this is EEG, and so on. Okay? Because what we are afraid of, okay, some of our students, for instance, you are not learning yet, like medical imaging, medical imaging system, and so on. But sometimes, okay, we don't know how to differentiate, okay, what is the name of this equipment, so that's the most unfortunate. So I hope for this course, okay, you can differentiate lah, okay, you can differentiate all this equipment, okay. Oops, what happened? Dengar tak?
Dengar.
Okay, dengar eh, tapi start tak bergerak eh. Okay, sekejap. Okay. Now they move. Okay. So, okay, we have three course outcomes. Okay. So this course outcome is very important because you want to know what, okay, what are the things that you learn. So this is like a summary of what you are going to learn. Okay, ability to identify. Okay, you identify, you apply. Okay, you distinguish, you differentiate sensors and transducers. To measure biological parameters. What are the biological parameters? All those brain signals, the blood pressures, okay, signals from your respiratory systems, okay. So these are the things. This is in the CO, the course outcomes number one. Okay, you identify, okay, then you can apply, okay,
Doctor,
and then you distinguish.
Doctor,
yeah.
The slide is not moving. The slide is not moving.
Course outcome. Is it on the course outcome?
No, still on the first page.
First synopsis, huh?
No, first page.
Still on the bioinstrumentation, huh?
Yeah, just now got moved.
Okay, how about this one?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, I don't know what happened to the computer. Okay, apa? But okay, if it is like this, okay. And then, okay, CO2, ability to discuss, okay, explain and analyze design requirements. So now, okay, you are able to discuss, okay, you can explain, okay, and then you analyze. So, okay, all the design requirements and also constraint lah, what are the kekangan lah, limits lah, okay, the limits for those medical devices, that's for CO2. Okay, the final one is a CO3, okay? The course outcome 3 is a ability to design, okay? You assemble, analyze, and evaluate basic circuit. So, these are those three course outcomes that, okay, you should have, okay, in the end of the course. Okay, so these are the teaching plan, okay? I know it is already uploaded in the Google Classroom, but please have a look. Please have a look. Okay. Okay. You have. Okay. I will teach you. I will be with you until the 5th week. Okay. And then I will come back on the 14th to 15th. Okay. So that's why I think I've told one of your friends about. Enlarge it a bit. Okay. Oh, too big. Okay. Because during my session, we'll be. Ramadan, okay, will be bulan puasa. Okay, if let's say we are doing it like from 4:30 to 6:30, okay, it will be unfortunate for our friends lah, okay, because they, okay, especially those who are in the campus, they you got to go and find food and so on, okay, so I hope you can have a discussion with Kaisi, okay. With your class rep, okay, with your class rep. Apa nama ni? Maybe, yeah, we can adjust it to any time convenient lah. Okay, where we don't have any clashes. Where we don't have any clashes. I hope that, I know, maybe in terms of what we call on paper, we maintain the 4:30 to 6:30 lah, but in reality we do it some other time. Okay, so okay, nanti kita then we discuss whether to maintain this time or should we go to other time lah, kan? Okay, because I was thinking of doing it at night, but yesterday we are supposed to have some sort like a async lecture at 9 o'clock, but I think okay during Ramadan we have tarawih and so on, so I think it's not appropriate lah, kan? So both of the time seems not that good. Okay, but we have more conversation like this, okay, in the future. So okay, keep on updating in the WhatsApp, okay now we go to the stuff, okay. So bioinstrumentation have been ages, okay. This is the, okay, in the past, if you look at the notes, the previous notes, okay, Since the time of Galileo, okay, and then you have a time since the you have apostasis, okay, during ancient Egypt, okay, and then I think you are going to find more things, okay, in the past. So actually, since humans have okay, they have sickness, okay, we have illness, we try to cure ourselves, okay. We try to make ourselves better, and since that time, bioinstrumentation somehow, somewhere exists. Okay, but we try to limit our scopes. Huh? Okay, I know that I told you in the first line. Okay, even thermometer we can say is a bioinstrumentation, but as you know that in the okay for us, okay, we try to okay it's something with yeah, it's run by electricity. Okay, so it's not a we're not going for the mechanical. We are not going for like thermometer. We are not going to biosensor. Okay, I will meet some of you. Okay, for biosensor next year. Okay, pregnancy testing. Okay, your what call COVID-19 this what call PCR test and so on. Okay, we are not going to that. Okay, actually, so but. Okay, we limit our scope. Okay, for this bioinstrumentation one, we limit our scope. Okay, so now we see what are the things that we are covering in this course. Okay. Okay. I hope you are still with me. Okay. Wah, masih ada lagi, ya? Okay. Medical instrumentation. Okay. Now the primary purpose. Okay. Look at the red one. Okay. I know. Most of the assessment, okay, assessment now we have open book exam, okay, we have an open book exam. Now we have test one, test two, okay, test one and test two, okay, is still about testing your memory, yeah, it's still about testing your memory. But for open book exam, it is bit tricky. You can open, okay. You can open your book, okay. You can Google, can use anything, okay. And perhaps, okay, one tricky thing, okay, you cannot discuss with your friend, okay. Unfortunately, some of you may discuss with your friends, but the worst thing is that your friend also cannot answer the question, or if they can answer the question, they might mislead you. So. There are a few things lah. Okay, that's why sometimes, okay, I cannot off-record the recording, but I want to say that if you don't understand, okay, for my part, okay, during the open book exam, you better WhatsApp me lah. Ask me, Atanesh. I want, okay, please kickstart lah kan. Macam mana nak, apa? Start the engine lah. Can you help me? Okay, I'll help you. But then, okay, like jump start your car, okay, don't ask me to drive you to JB lah kan, okay, don't ask me to drive you to JB or KL. I just start your car, okay, and then after that you drive lah wherever you want to go, okay. So if you have a problem, especially during the open book exam, okay, first of all, okay, you need, okay, first of all, you need to study, okay, and then you need to what we call make a plan how to answer the question, okay. So and if let's say you have problem, don't ask your friends, ask your lecturer, because I'm the one that write your questions. It's not them, okay. So please ask me, don't ask them, okay. If you ask them, you might from 15 marks you may get okay 8 marks, and much worse is the lectures. Yeah, this is the same. Okay, we have the same script. That's the worst of all. So first, okay. So during open book exam, please ask the lecturers. Don't ask your friends. Okay. So coming back to this, okay, medical instrumentation. The primary purpose. Okay, what are the primary purpose? Okay. You want to measure or determine the presence of the physical quantity coming from your body. So That's why modern science is all about. Okay. Just imagine, okay, people like last time, if you, I don't know whether you play, I don't play games, okay, but yeah, I watch movies, okay. Last time, people talking about maybe like magic or something, yeah, okay. But then after the Renaissance, okay, we start to learn about what? Okay, there's heat, okay, there's pressure, time, okay, all those things. So these are the what we call the physical quantity. So from our body, we have physical quantity. So what are they? Okay. You go to Yasmin, you check your temperature. That's a physical quantity. Heat coming from your body become your temperature. So okay, we okay, try okay. One thing when you learn this, okay, I know some of you may split this, okay. Like whatever you learn here in the class, nothing to do with the real world, so that's wrong. Okay. So I hope that everything that you learn in the class, okay, you can relate it with the outside world, with the real world, Don't chuck this into your bag or just put it in, just keep it in your laptop, Okay, please think and relate it with the real world. Okay, for instance, okay, you are going to diagnose people. Okay, check. Okay, diagnose. I know. That's why that's why like in law, in even in religion, like in our for biomedical engineers, okay, we use jargons, So jargons like this, diagnosis, okay, it's actually check, okay. Okay, you want to check a person, okay, if you go to Yasmin, you want to go in, check the temperature, so you check the temperature. So with while you check the temperature, you diagnose the temperature, okay, you know, okay, this person have a high temperature, beep, okay, sounds beep, and then you know, okay, this guy is okay, it's not well because most probably he got a fever, he got a fever. Okay, so after that we go further, okay, we go further. What happened? Okay, maybe he got COVID or not, and so on. Okay, so that's for so when you are diagnosing, you're doing diagnosis, you know what are the condition of a person or in some cases your patients. Okay, I don't want to dwell so much, because we just have like 5 o'clock. Okay, treatment. Okay, treatment like what? Like for instance, your syringe pump. You want to inject something. Syringe pump. Okay, that's for treatment. Okay, sometimes you do for your rehabilitation. Okay, but there are okay. Majority of what we are going to discuss, okay, throughout the whole course, is electrical electronics, based on electrical or electronic systems, like I told you just now, the differentiation between common the what called the thermometer that we have, and also your infrared thermometer in like most of places we see now, okay. But they also mechanical systems. Okay, we can say that our thermometer, our old time thermometer, you can say mechanical systems. Okay, maybe like for instance, like a ventilator. Okay, in the past is 100% mechanical. Okay, in maybe like in 1940s and 1930s. Okay, so they are not much of electrical or electric systems. Okay, so we go. This is a bit brief. Okay. This diagnostic equipments, okay. Stethoscope. This is a, you can say it's mechanical. It has a diaphragm, diaphragm, okay. It vibrates, when you put it on your chest, it vibrates, and then the doctor will hear the sound of your heartbeat, Okay, semua dengar lagi, Okay ke?
Okay.
Okay, saya check from time to time, takut. Okay, time to time, takut apa nama ni. Okay, I lost the connection, something happens. Although I subscribe to 300 megabyte per second UniFi, tapi sometimes, okay, I do lost my connection. Okay, so how about this one? Okay, ultrasound machine. Okay, this also Diagnosing, ya. Diagnostic. Senang cakap lah. Okay, I told you just now. Check. It's just to check. Check the baby. Check your heartbeat. Okay. So that's the meaning of diagnostic. Okay. But as you know, we like to use jargon lah kan. Okay. To make we look important. So that's why we have all these terms. Mobile C-arm. Maybe this is our X-ray. Yeah. And then ECG machine to look at your heart signal. ECG. Yeah. Okay. Then you have therapeutic. Okay, therapeutic. How many example we have? Okay, therapeutic. Defib. Okay. So the heart of the patient stops. So what you're going to do? You defib. Okay. We will learn this more in the bioinstrumentation too. I taught this like 4 years back. I think 4 3 years 4 years back. Okay. Infusion pump. So you want to infuse maybe. Drugs, okay, so on, okay, and then ventilator, okay, to help people to, now I think you are when there's a COVID now, okay, there are more things that closer to us now, okay, ventilator to help you how to breathe, okay, and then the transcutaneous electrical nerve stimulator, okay. When the person have problems, nerve problems, okay, you want to stimulate it to make it works again, your nerve, okay, then we use your tens. So all of these, okay, therapeutic, okay, you want to treat, okay, now, okay, easy, okay, one is to check, okay, another one is to treat, okay, so I'm not sure, are there anybody of you from KKTM Ledang, ada tak? Tak ada. Okay. Okay, I see no answer. Okay, so none of you from KKTM Ledang. Okay, KKTM Ledang, they have a few courses lah. Okay, one of them is diagnostic, therapeutic, and then they have labs, and they have another two. I forgot already. I forgot. Okay, but okay, this is how we categorize, okay, types of medical instrumentation. Okay, but one thing, okay, do we have any international students here? Ada international students?
Yes, doctor.
Okay, where are you from?
From Yemen.
Oh, from Yemen. Okay. Good.
Yes.
Because okay, I'm sorry, because sometimes I thought that, okay, maybe all of you are local students, and sometimes, yeah, okay. I hope throughout the lecture, okay, or even I use some Bahasa Melayu here, but it is not that bad, okay. I hope you understand my lecture. Like, okay. Okay, so.
Yes, okay.
Okay. Okay, thank you. Thank you for your reply. Okay, so although I might categorize these devices into just two, but you have to remember one thing, okay? This is only a guide, okay? Don't go and next time maybe you have another friend from biomedical engineering, okay? They say, okay, device of medical instrumentation is not just only diagnostic and therapy, it has blah, 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 blah. They listed like 10 of them. Okay, actually, it's maybe the way they categorize the medical instrumentation, maybe not wrong. Okay, maybe not wrong. Okay, but to simplify things to you today, at this moment, we just confine ourselves to two types of biomedical instrumentation. Okay, so we have this diagnostic and also therapeutic. Okay, but it doesn't mean that all bioinstrumentation should be categorized. Maybe some of them, like I told you, that how the KKTM Ledang, okay, they categorize, okay, the courses. They have another one like for rehabilitation devices. They have, but I think we just confine it to two types only. Okay. Okay. Now I call this a powerful diagram. Okay. I hope you are still with me. Okay. A medical system, okay, or medical instrumentation, you can say it should have a diagram like this, okay, where you have something to be measured, measuring. Okay, one thing, okay, not only for the purpose of examination, but also in your life, okay. You should, okay, I know, when we put this measurement, okay, this measurements, okay, some of you may not, like for instance, during the exam tests or quiz or something, okay, you feel blank. And then you say that, what is this, Okay, let's say if you cannot remember, okay, it's okay. You just put like you just say bio signals. Okay, it's okay as long as I know what you mean. Okay, as long as I know what you mean, as long as you know what you mean. Okay, what you are trying to say. Okay, I can accept it as a full marks. Okay, but yeah. Because for me, the most important thing for you, okay, is to understand the course. Okay, because now we are, okay, like for me, okay, I'm already 43, okay, because I know one lecturer, she make like a quiz, okay, ask what is my age, okay, some of you may, I don't know lah, if I don't tell my age, or What age do you put? They put 58, wadah, oh, tahu lah. So, okay. Okay, coming back. Okay. When you're getting old, okay, 42, sometimes, okay. The most important part is that you understand instead of you try to memorize the course. You try to memorize the course, okay. But I know, it's better for you to memorize the course than, okay, first of all, the highest level is the, okay, you understand. Okay, you understand. And how do you, okay, that's why, we're coming back to the course outcome and so on. How we know that you understand, okay? How the employer knows how do you understand, okay? So that's why you know how to discuss. You know how to explain. Okay, you know how to evaluate, okay, because all this wording, okay, because I know the outcome, the real outcome, okay, is that I understand this course. So simple, right? Okay, but how to understand you, how to know that you understand? Okay, that's why we give you the quizzes, the tests, okay, assignments, okay, to see whether you can apply all this. Okay, that's why in this course, okay, the lowest level is that memorization, because you just memorize and then you just spit it out, okay, habis, okay, finish, okay. Then that's why if you understand this course, this course, okay, it's easy for you to mention all this, okay. Like I told you, I want to tell you, okay. Then for instance, what are the first thing? What is the first box here? Measurements, the things that you are going to measure, the signal you are going to measure. Okay, what is the thing that going to detect? Okay, to sense the thing that you are going to measure. It should be sensors. Yeah, make sense now? I know you're sleepy. Okay, especially in the Friday's afternoon. Okay, after Jumaat prayer. Okay, for those who went to the masjid, the mosque. Okay. So. Something that sense it. So what happened after you sense it? Okay, after you have detected it. Because it comes in raw signal. Those zigzag, okay. Now you are going to process it. The signal conditioning. You're going to process it. That's why I told you, if you say sensor, maybe all of you can memorize sensor, no problem, kan? Okay, so about this part, okay. So if you cannot say, okay, signal conditioning, what happened here, signal processing, you can say signal processing, because this raw signal, you cannot understand it, kan? Okay, like for instance, the temperature, the heat, the heat from your body. Okay. Let's say we use a thermometer, the old style thermometer using mercury. It goes up to that number 37. Then you know, that's signal processing lah. Okay, that's a signal processing. Then when you saw you saw it up to 37, it's a display. That's for the old style, but for us, from your what I call the infrared thermometer, the heat from the body, then the your infrared thermometer process it, then you see, this is 36.2. So this is the display. So all the this especially for the diagnostic, medical system, you can jot down there, medical system is really diagnostic, should have these four block diagrams. Four block diagrams. So from there you elaborate, you tambah lagi, you elaborate, you add up more. What type of measurement here? Can be radiation, electrical current, any energy. Because it can be electricity for electrical form, like for instance your ECG and so on, radiation, yeah, your heat, So the measurement, maybe you need the calibration signal, and then the sensor, signal conditioning, maybe you need to store the data, the sensor, sometimes like I told you about your mercury thermometer, doesn't need any power, but let's say it's your infrared thermometer, it needs battery, or AC current. Do you need to control or not? For instance, control and feedback. For instance, that the system that you have in your restaurant, if you are 38 degrees, you need to beep. So you have a control and feedback. Kan? You have a control and feedback. Data transmission, maybe you need it online. Then the perceptive output. So you need to understand this block diagram. That's why I told you. This is a powerful diagram, a very powerful diagram. Learn it, understand it, Then if any questions come, you can answer this question. Faham lah? Boleh? Insya boleh. This is the page 12. We have 20 more to go. So I've already, tak apa lah kan, because I've already gone very long, on the block diagram. So the simple sajalah sini, we make it simple here, so the primary flow, we have the primary flow just now is the dark line, the dark line and dark block diagram, then you have the dash line, the dash line, it depends, like I told you about the beep just now, if the person have 38 degrees. The restaurant, Yasmin restaurant, need to know whether the guy is having fever or not. So we can stop him, from entering the restaurant. So we have that control system. But it is optional. Sometimes, like for instance, your handheld, doesn't have to. So it doesn't mean it may have. You may not. So that's why, here. Just make a comparison. One thing, about like my typical question, I'm not sure about the time fee. I like to ask comparison. I like to ask comparison because when you compare, especially the one that you don't study in your, you don't have in your lecture notes, means that you understand the content. For instance, just now, maybe we compare with is the one thermometer we have in the restaurant and also simple one. So you know the difference, you can understand, because usually the one that this one the old style is a very fundamental. We go this is also a nice statement here. It's a nice statement. Bear with me, okay? The major difference, okay, between the medical and conventional instrumentation systems is that the source of signal comes from living tissue. Or, okay, you are going to apply to living tissue. For instance, just now the tens, the transcutaneous nervous system, okay, this, okay, we apply the energy to the living tissue. Defibrillator, you apply the energy to the living tissue. Pacemaker, perentak jantung, pacemaker, you put to make the rhythm of your heart, it's okay, so it is also the energy applied to living tissue. So difference between medical and also other type of instrumentation systems is that, okay, the source of signals, okay, come, okay, the sources, the source, okay, the source comes from the living tissue, okay. If you want to do the therapeutic, okay, the energy, okay, you are going to use, okay, it's going to apply to the living tissue. Then you go to the system components, okay. So now, okay, we are going to, okay, study one by one lah about the block diagram, okay. The measurement, okay, the physical quantity, property or condition that the system measures. So that's what I told you, okay, the signal, the bio signals, okay, and so on. So it's a thing, is the thing that you are going to sense, okay. So these are the category, the category of the thing you're going to measure, the measurement, okay, is it coming from the blood pressure, okay, internal, is it, okay, blood pressure on the body surface, okay, so on the body surface, electrocardiogram, okay, emanate from the body, for instance, your temperature, okay, maybe this from the tissue sample, okay, this was a diagnostic, and by virus sensor, we can see it's a diagnostic equipment, okay. So okay, we will go this further in another topic, okay. So measurement is something you're going to sense, okay, to put it simple, okay, you can say it's a signal, okay, it's a signal or something that you're going to sense, okay. Okay, then you have what? Okay, sensors, okay. Sensors usually form a transducer. So, what is a transducer? Okay, repeating this again and again and again, okay. Few courses, okay. We repeat this again and again and again, okay. It converts one form of energy to another. What is it? Okay, for instance, what are the example? Good example, strong example. Okay, like for instance, for ultrasound, you have a piezoelectric transducer, so it transforms the sound wave, okay, the sound wave, okay, coming from the baby, okay, and then it transform, okay, the sounds, okay, then you have a picture. So that's the transducer, okay. What else? Like for instance, the typical your simple thermometer, okay. The transducer is the thermometer itself is transducer, but the mercury, okay, from heat, okay, then, okay, you can see the temperature, the mercury moves up, okay, and then you can say that, okay, you see, okay, then you translate it from your side, okay, you see, okay, it's at 37 degrees Celsius, okay. So, okay, that is a thermometer, but let's say, okay, let's say in terms of ultrasound, okay, a sensor converts the physical measurement to an electrical output. So why electrical output? Because this electrical output, you can change it into a display that you can understand. Okay, a display that you can understand. Yeah. Okay, it should be selective, only respond to the energy in the measure and to the execution of all of this. So, okay, this sensor, okay, this sensor should, like for instance, if you want to measure EEG, okay, only the brain signals that will be measured by the system, by the sensor, sorry, by the sensor, not other type of. So other type of signals, we can treat it as a noise. Okay. So there are few. Okay, here is a important terms that you should concentrate. Okay. The meaning of transducer. Okay. This is a part of the sensor. Okay. Okay, what is transducer? Transducer converts one form of energy to another. Sensor, okay, changes from the physical signals, okay, to electrical signals, okay, electrical output. And then, okay, that sensor should be selective. Like, for instance, biosensor, okay, a biosensor to detect glucose, it only detect glucose. It doesn't detect sucrose, it doesn't detect fructose, just glucose. Okay, so it must be very selective. Okay, and then one thing is that, okay, it should interface with the living system. It's a way that minimizes the energy accepted. Okay, and then should be, okay, not minimally invasive. Okay, so this is for safety. Okay, this is more on the, what we call more on the optimization lah of the energy. Yeah? Okay. Okay, you're going to let me finish the system components. Okay, and then after that we have a break. Okay, sekejap lah, we can pay all that. Okay, so bukan bulan puasa, it's not Ramadan yet, so after that we cannot lah, kan? Okay, so okay, signal conditioning. So you're going to process the signal. Okay, so what are the signal processing do? Okay, you may amplify the signal. Sometimes the signal is very weak, so you want to make it large. Okay, so you can, so the system can measure it. Okay, can understand what happened. Filter, I told you, noise. Like if you use an ECG, okay, whether it is really comes from your heart, or it comes from your throat, from your stomach. Okay, right. The grumbling, okay, so this is okay. So you need to filter, okay, or merely match the impedance of the sensor to the display. Okay, so these are the things that the signal conditioning do. Okay, often sensor outputs are converted to digital form and processed by specialized digital circuits or microphone computer. So why? Because we need to understand it. We need to understand the outputs, and then it's converted to digital form. That's right. How you are, okay? Because I think from my time, okay, when I was a student, okay, and to you, okay, until your time here now, okay, you as a student, we may not be appreciate this, okay. But I'm not sure how many of you have heard songs, okay, from before Piramli time, okay, like in the 50s or 60s. Okay, it sounds too bad, man. You know, this is something ancient, something from very, very past, okay. You can see, okay, I don't know, I'm not asking you to find those music, okay, but I know sometimes you open the classical channel or something, yeah, you see the, or even you watch your Piramli films, okay, the sounds are very, very bad. But if you hear a song from the 80s, okay, 90s, you can differentiate whether this is a new song or an old song. Why? Because of the ability of our technology to convert it to digital form. Okay, last time we only have the analog. Okay, one thing. Okay, maybe that for instance, lah. Okay, I hope we don't have any like big disaster, like a disaster that makes a dinosaur extinct. Okay. Ah, what happening? Okay, you can see that the pictures from maybe your parents, in the 80s or even 90s, okay, they are blur, right? Okay, but you can see that, okay, when it is like 2 or 3 years, 5 years, okay, 5 years, it's going to blur. But then if, let's say in terms of, okay, you keep it in your laptop, you take the picture by using the digital camera, it is always like that. Because there are no signals lost. But if you put it like in terms of the old picture, okay, it will be okay, we will lose the what called the pixel, we can say part of the because of the temperature and so on. So it happens to the analog. Okay? So now all the signal conditioning, okay, because of the digital form, we can have a better display. Okay. Finally, on this, okay, output display, the result must be displayed in a form that human operator can perceive. So much of the display now, maybe like for instance, temperature, okay, it is in numbers, okay. I know some, okay, like ECG, okay, ECG, EEG, sometimes difficult lah because it's in the, okay, that's why you learn about ECG or PQRST and so on. But as long as we can understand, okay, what does it presents, okay, it is okay. This is another one, lah, okay. Okay, although most display rely on visual sensors, okay, like digital display, like the temperature, okay, or maybe like ECG in the what I call a waveform, okay. Maybe it can be helped by other sensors, like hearing, okay, maybe touching or something. Okay. And then system components, okay, this is accessory lah, the auxiliary component. Not accessory, auxiliary component, okay. A calibration signal with properties of the measurement should be applied to sensor input as early in the signal processing chain as possible. Okay, so maybe this will help, okay, the sensor to sense the signal. Okay, so sometimes we have a calibration signal, okay. And then I told you about the control and feedback, okay, maybe like for instance, to elicit the measurement, okay, to adjust the sensor, to condition, okay, to improve the signal, okay, to direct the flow of output for display, okay, and so I told you also about the beep or something, the beep, okay, to set, okay, that like the temperature of the person is high, okay, means that this guy is having fever and so on. So control and feedback also can be a part of the auxiliary component. Okay, and then data storage, okay. You need to keep it, okay. Sometimes not in real time, you need, maybe you want to what call have it later on, okay. Okay, and then maybe a conventional principle of communication. Okay, now we have all these wireless and so on. So this represents on the fourth point. Okay, after this we have a break and maybe 5 minutes. Okay, before we go to the classification of medical devices. Okay, semua lagi ya. Hello, Nagom. Hey there. Yeah. Okay, thank you. Okay. So device operational modes, okay, whether this is a direct mode or indirect. We can say that, okay, like even ECG, we can say is quite indirect, okay. Direct mode, Okay, for instance, like our temperature. Okay. We use something that very close to us now. Okay, temperature. Direct mode. We take a thermometer, put it down your armpit. It's direct. Okay. Indirect. Okay. Maybe yeah. You take you use the the handheld. Okay. It's quite indirect. Sampling mode, infrequent monitor of slow changing measurements. Okay. And then continuous. Okay. So sampling, maybe yeah, I know. Maybe this is not really yeah. It's sometimes time to time. For instance, it doesn't happen all the time. Okay. Like for instance, I cannot use this contoh, but I think you can understand this. Like for instance, okay. How many birds flying? Okay, in Aral. Okay, you just take a sampling mode lah from like 2 o'clock to 3 o'clock. Okay, 2 o'clock to 4 o'clock. You make a sample. Okay, you make a sample there. Oh, you okay? Today you take it from 2 to 4. Tomorrow you take it from 2 to 4. So you make a sampling mode. Okay, maybe you can use it like for instance, to check the blood glucose or something. Okay, by sampling. Okay. Maybe just like continuous. They can be continuous. For instance, to check maybe like, you know, for the patient monitoring. So it could be continuous. It can be continuous. Okay. Generating sensors, okay, produce signal output for energy taken directly from the measurement. Okay. Okay. And then the modulating sensors, the measurement alters the energy flow from the external source. So there are two things. Whether, okay. You get the signal directly, okay, from the thing that you're okay, from the biosignal that you're measuring, or maybe the measurement, okay, will alter the energy, okay, flow from the source of your biosignals, okay. Okay, analog mode, I told you, okay, continuous signal able to take any value within a dynamic range. Another one, discrete signal. Only able to take on a finite number of values. Okay, it's analog, and then digital. Another one is real time. You do it now. Another one is that okay, you can take it this time. Okay, you can measure this time. Later on, you will process it. Okay, so we have done it like more than because we have 32 slides. 32 slides. Okay, so we stop at 20. So please give me like 5 minutes break. Okay. Anybody just come in? Okay, let's see now. Can I paste the attendance? Okay. So see you in 5 minutes, huh? Okay, hope all of you are ready. Okay. Okay, semua sedia eh. Okay, now it's 4:21. Okay. So we just have a few slides more to go. I will give you the recording on the async, okay? Maybe I'm sorry, Casey, okay? We have to continue our discussion a bit later, okay? Maybe after the class, okay? So now okay, for the async class, okay, I will give you like maybe next week, okay, early next week, okay, I will record the async, okay. Watanabe is a good colleague of mine, and he has a very wonderful suggestion. He said that maybe for the async, it shouldn't be long, okay. Like 1 hour or something, okay. Maybe we should make it like 50 minutes, okay. Most is 20 minutes, 50 minutes, okay. 10 minutes, 50 minutes. I should do that, okay. Because I think it's easier for you, So any clips, if like you saw YouTube, YouTube please, if you see alamak, it's six minutes, it's okay. But then if you see, alamak, this is 15 minutes lah. I have to spend 15 minutes on the at the mobile lah, the phone lah, to have a look. You think twice lah. Okay, start. Okay, is it on the 21? 21st? 21? PowerPoint number 31? Is it okay? Betul tak?
Yes, doctor.
Okay. Thank you. Okay. So, like I told you, there are a few classification as a general. Okay, this is not what we call this is not an absolute classification. Okay, but for time being, for the purpose of the course, okay, we just hold this classification. Yeah. So we have a medical devices. Then you have how to categorize a quantity sense, okay, maybe temperature, the flow, okay, and then maybe you want to measure, okay, signals from certain types of organ systems, like for instance from cardiovascular, from the pulmonary, maybe the nervous system, maybe skeletal systems, okay, depends on what type of systems that you have, okay. Maybe in terms of the sensor, okay, the non-sensor, better say transduction, okay. If you look at them, sorry again. In terms of the how does it the conversion of the signals, okay. So how does it work, okay? By resistive, by is it capacitive, inductive, or ultrasonic, and so on, and maybe. In terms of what I call, if you look at this, okay, pediatrics, obstetrics, cardiology, radiology is more like a specialist department. But yeah, maybe you can say that, okay, you can categorize it according to the specialties. Okay, specialties. So these are the types, okay, of how you're going to classify the medical device. Okay, so that. Why you need it? Why you need to do this? Because you need to, maybe you have, okay, you want to explain it to your customer, okay, to the end user, not customer, like end user, okay, you want to mention it to your end user, okay, who is your end user? Maybe like you say that cardiologists, okay, cardiologists need what type of, they should have an ECG and so on, radiologists, maybe they need ultrasound, they need X-ray and so on. Okay, what type of system, okay, maybe like, okay, and so on, okay. Okay, I want to dwell this much longer, okay, but I hope you understand the the principle. Okay, why is this war? Actually, this is just how you're going to classify the medical device. Okay, this is not an absolute classification. Okay, but it gives you some idea how we categorize the medical devices. Okay. Okay. So now we are going to more like like statistics, the plots and so on. Okay. So you want to see the instrument characteristics. Okay. So the characteristic of instrument performance. Okay. So you divided into static and dynamic characteristic. Okay. Usually are based on the frequency of the input signals. Okay. So this will provide a quantitative criteria, okay, of the performance of instrument that are needed. So, okay, you have you are going to divide, okay, the characteristic of the instrument performance according to the static and dynamic characteristic. Okay, usually it's based on the frequency, okay, of the input signals. Okay, and this provide a quantitative criteria for the performance of instrument that are needed. This criteria must clearly specify how well an instrument measures the desired output and how much output depends on interfering and modifying input. So all these are the instrument characteristics that you need. Okay. So the first one is static characteristic. Okay, describes the performance of instrument for direct current DC or very low efficiency inputs. Okay. The properties of the output for a wide range of constant inputs demonstrate the quality of the measurement. Okay, so including a non-linear and statistical effects. Okay, so what are the instruments or the sensors that involve? Okay, piezoelectric devices. Okay, response only to time-varying inputs and have no static characteristic. Okay. So static characteristic. So if we go to this concept, which is accuracy and precision. Okay, I still remember during doing physics when I was in when I was 16. Okay, in Malaysia they call Form 4. Form 4. They call it kejituan dan kepersisan. Kejituan dan kepersisan. Okay, so accuracy. Okay, I'm sorry for the international students. Okay. Accuracy means how accurate is it? Okay. This can be the... Okay. Okay, this is... I know. If you can... I think this... I don't really like the... this diagram. I don't really like this diagram because for precision, for position is okay because you can see a cluster of these dots. Okay, what is accuracy? Okay, accuracy means that, go to the meaning. Okay, degree of conformity between the measurement and the standard. I think okay, this is two keys. Okay. Accuracy means that it is accurate, straight to the point. I mean, using this analogy. Okay, so everything, okay, accurate and precise. Okay, so if it is accurate and precise, it should hit everything. Okay, bullseye here. Okay. But if it is just accurate, okay, it is near to the, center, okay. But it doesn't have the pattern, okay. It doesn't have the pattern. But precision means that you always hit, okay. You are very consistent of, okay, hitting this part of the board, Okay, but you don't hit the bullseye. You don't get the center. Okay, and the end is that if it is not accurate and it's not precise, so it's everywhere. It's nearly everywhere. It's nearly everywhere. So these are the but I don't really like the diagram, okay, because the diagram doesn't show the accuracy and precision at the same time, okay. And then the accuracy, if it is accurate, maybe you can put it encircling here, eh? Encircling here, okay. And okay. So precision is okay. This is nice. This is nice. This is a nice example. Okay. If it's not accurate and precision, it should be everywhere. Here you have dot. Here you have dot. Here you have dot. Here you have dot. But it's nowhere. Okay, it's nowhere here. Okay. So, okay, accuracy refers to the degree of conformity between the measurement and the standard. Precision refers to the degree of refinement of measurement. So, gitu, I told you. So you can confirm, okay, the measurement and the standard. Okay, we come here to the slide. Okay. So, like a standard. Okay, the standard says that PQRST looks like this lah. Eh? Okay, PQRST. Okay, you know this, nah. Don't say that until your end of your third year, you still don't know your PQRST. Yeah. Okay, dengan cakap macam tu, don't say that. Okay, you don't know what is PQRST. So, when you have your pandemani, when you have your reading from the ECG, okay, you make your own ECG, okay? You try, okay, from a healthy person, that from the from a standard ECG device, okay? They have, he got that signal, okay? So, when you do it, okay, it is accurate. It is okay. I got the signal. It reads the PQRST. Same as, or nearly the same as, okay, the ECG comes from the standard ECG. Coming from the acceptable brand of ECG. Okay. So precision refers to the degree of refinement of the measurement. So you always, okay, the measurement is defined. Okay, you always get that measurement. Okay. Resolution is the smallest incremental quantity that can be measured with certainty. So resolution, okay, that's why I told you, I always told my students, you are lucky to study in this age, okay. You can play resolution in your computer with your mobile phone, okay. But easiest for me to, okay, especially those who wear spectacles, okay, rabun, those who cannot see, okay, without your glass, resolution, okay, if the resolution is not good, you have that blur. If the resolution is good, it's very sharp. So that's the meaning of resolution. Okay. So if, let's say, you have a small dot, you can see the small dark dot there, means that the resolution is good. Okay. If you see that it start to blurish or something, means that, okay, the resolution is not that good. Okay. Repeatability, okay, means that you can have the same answer, okay, when you do the measurement, okay. Like for instance, okay, you do the a person that is should have 37 degrees, okay. Every time you measure his temperature, it will be 37. It doesn't become 32, no. It doesn't become 38. It doesn't become 42. It doesn't become 16. It doesn't become, like for instance, sometimes you go to the shop, to kedai, the shop, okay. When you check, your temperature is 22. Nah, sabar. Is it possible you have the 22? I know, because of the aircon and so on. But let's say, it keeps on giving that result, 22, 16. That means something wrong with that. Then you know the repeatability. It's not good. Okay. So, okay, statistical control ensures that random variations in measured quantities that result from all factors that influence the measurement process tolerable. Okay, so. Okay, you can have the storable. Static sensitivity is the ratio of the incremental output quantity to the incremental input quantity. Okay, you don't have a zero drift, okay? When all the output values increase or decrease by the same absolute amount, okay, and then the sensitivity drift, okay, causes error that is proportional to the magnitude of input, okay? So you can see the plots now, eh? Okay? This is a good one, okay? You have, all your measurement. This is an acceptable measurement, okay? So you have a sensitivity drift and then the zero drift, okay? So what is the total error is here? You should have this is the characteristic with zero and the sensitivity drift, okay? So this is the design that you want, okay? And then then you have the static characteristics, okay? Linearity. So this is the linear, linear representation. Input ranges, normal linear operating range specify the maximum input that give linear output, okay? Because this is important. This is important because like certain devices, in terms of normal life that we have, all our medical equipments have been undergone a very thorough research, we know the limits and so on. But let's say you are going to make a new device, new device from new materials, from a new maybe a new design, sometimes it is a challenge actually, this you can see all these plots and graphs when you are designing or you want to characterize a newly developed system, that is still under research. Sometimes, you need to tolerate, for instance, when you have an input of this type of current, it will be linear until how many ampere, maybe just the 5 milliampere and so on. It will give you a linear input. Maybe in certain temperature it will give this will be good, but after maybe 100 degrees it starts to go haywire. So maybe in terms of the devices that we have now, you don't really see troubles, but then if let's say that's right, sometimes if you want to make a biosensor, because I taught biosensors, this 2014 is that 8 years or 9 years already I've been teaching biosensors. That for instance, if you can develop a biosensor, for certain type, if you look at the proteins, it is quite and unless for those in the field, it's quite what we call incomprehensible. You cannot understand it, unless if you're in the field. So it's in the certain modes. So that's why you need to understand the characteristic of the medical device. And then you have this input impedance ratio of the phasor equivalent of a steady state. Effort input to flow input variable and this one. And then you have the dynamic characteristic. Because sometimes you need to use the differential or integral equations to describe the quality of the measurement. Sometimes you have to use a transfer function in order to predict the output of the system. And then you have it is a zero order instrument, a derivative where the output is proportional to the input for all frequencies. One of example is a linear potentiometer, and then you have a first order instrument. The instrument or device have a single energy storage element. Maybe it has a low pass filter, RC filter. Second order instrument. For instance, force measuring spin scale. And then about time delay instrument that produce exactly the same output as input. okay, however, with delay times, okay? And then the time delay requires a signal, significant signal processing scheme, okay, in order to solve it, okay, to implement it, okay? So, we have finished our first chapter today, okay? This is an old book, okay? Medical instrumentation, okay? Who is this writer? Webster, we can say is a father of biomedical engineering, okay? Biomedical engineering. Kanpur, okay, he's also a famous professor from India. And then Carr, okay? This is also a famous professor in biomedical engineering. Okay, so now is 4:40. Okay, I will stop the recording. Okay, just start recording. Okay, for those who hasn't filling your attendance, okay, I've just the attendance, okay, so I hope you can fill it in. Okay, ada apa soalan?
For the attendance, we need to choose our name from the list, but because I did manual registration, the subject is not in the system yet. I need to wait for next. Yeah, my name is not there.
Okay. Okay. So, how is it? Okay. This is an issue. Okay, I understand. How? It's just simple issue, but it's okay. Maybe you just how is it? Never mind. Okay, it's okay. Don't worry. Okay, I don't.
Okay. I send my name and my mic.
Okay,
who are you?
Okay. Okay, we are recording it. So this is the proof that you are here.
Okay.
Happy. Okay.
Thank
who
you.
Else? Okay, no problem. They have a saying here. We make the system, not the other way around. So it's okay. Okay. So, siapa lagi? Who else? Who else have the same problem? Because you know, okay. If you keep quiet, okay, we don't know your problem. Siapa lagi masalah sama? Ya, episode.
Left macam mana ada attending tu?
Dah tak dengar sekali?
Ada attending untuk left ke?
I think so. Ada. There will be lah, but now we just go for lecture first, okay? You will have a session, the lab session, mungkin ada the lab session dengan Dr. Nafi. You will have a lab session with Dr. Nafi during his time lah. For now, for my session, we just have a case study lah. Kita cuma ada case study saja lah.
Group lab tu masih bahagikan ikut grup 1-2 dengan XTIP macam itu ataupun buat dua grup?
Saya tengah bincang dengan KCT, okay, dengan your class lab, okay. But after that, I will also lower hand. Okay. Sorry. So after that, I will discuss with Dr. Nafi lah whether he agree with it or not lah, the formation kan. Okay. Okay, Bijo, thank you. Ada lagi ya?
Doktor.
Okay. Ya.
For the suggestion of the changing the schedule to Wednesday 8-10, how about we ask everyone to raise their hand if they agree or not?
I think we will. Okay. That is okay. Okay. If there's nothing about the about attendance and so on, okay, I will stop recording, okay, then we discuss. Okay.